Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with another episode of the Fuga walkthrough. And things are about to get very nasty very quick. As in this chapter, we're going to fight a boss who can take us from about of a quarter of our health to dead instantly, as I'm hopefully future me can show a clip of pretty soon. Right, future me? Right? Yeah, you're a good little chap like that. So then, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this. So yeah, this chapter is when things are going to start getting very, real. Up until now, it's been very paw-holdy. Well, I say that. We fought about a dozen drones, already fought an enemy colonel, and we fought a mobile artillery piece. But other than that, it's been pretty chill. Well, that's all about to end today. So, yeah, let's just get into it. We're gonna have another fight here pretty soon. Is that the rumored giant tank? Contact camp! We can't let them go! Woohoo! I'm sort of feeling awesome today. Let me help out in battle. Aren't you spunky? Don't overdo it and hurt yourself, okay? Hehe, it'll be alright. I feel invincible. Alright then, combat started. And it's a single Zyklon, okay. The mood of characters who are feeling great gradually increase in battle and will eventually reach its max, activating Hero Mode. You can see when the children's mood increases by the icon's color and the number of stars. Increasing mode mood condition 1. Hit the enemy or get hit by the enemy. Increasing mood condition 2. The lower the Taranis HP, the greater the increase. Alright then. Let's raise Hack's mood all the way. Alright then. So, Hack switches to hero mode. Hero mode lasts for 5 turns, so be sure to take advantage of it before it wears off. Hero mode effects are different for each child, so please check their status from the main menu. Alright then, so yeah, hero mode. So basically, when they're feeling good, because last episode we did an intermission where we cleared out a lot of their tasks that make them happy. Well, when you do them, this is the mode you get. So, as it said, each of theirs is special. In Hack's case, he gets triple action speed after normal attacks. So here we use the cannon, and yeah, he'll use it again fairly soon. Yeah, it actually shows on the top bar. If it's a normal attack, then we'll get to actually attack again before the Zyklon can even really react. So, yeah, this is a good hero mode. Some of the hero modes aren't so good. They can be a bit, hit or miss at times, but this is a pretty good one. Now, before we get into it, I want to actually change our setup a little bit. So, of course, we do need a machine gunner. And, yeah, I feel Kyle and Hannah will be pretty good. But I do want to show off the new characters and their abilities as much as possible. And I also want to take advantage of the link between Hack and Malt, because, yeah, Malt's effect increases attack, and Hack is sort of all about doing lots of damage, so yeah, that fits pretty good. Alright then, now let's finally get into this. So, normal attack, that's fine. Wow, 102 damage, not bad. Now let's get rid of some of its armor. Perfect. Now then, Chick, what are your abilities? Oh yeah, so Chick, kind of like Hannah, starts off with Lullaby, so she does have a bit of healing. She also has this funny little thing called Stun Grenade, attack that may inflict shock on an enemy. Now, shock is basically an effect that will keep the enemy from being able to attack. It doesn't have the best chance of hitting, but it's a very powerful effect. It's basically a stun that lasts an absurdly, and I do mean an absurdly, long time. So let's go ahead and test this out. And please apply the shock effect. There we go. Thank you. And now, because of Hack's hero mode, we're already going to attack again. And now, he gets to attack already! Yeah, it's pretty... a little bit broken at times. Alrighty then. That is a dead Zyklon. What do we have next? Oh yeah, we're doing the Yaghound thing again. Although we do have a new enemy here. The R-Schwarm. Which I'm pretty sure Schwarm in German means swarm. Berman's support drone with a high evasion rate. It doesn't attack, but will support ground enemy units by restoring their HP. Target it first. So yeah, these things are really fun to deal with. So anytime these, you know, hound tanks, or any other enemy that might be on the field, are injured, then this will go ahead and restore its hull. Now keep in mind, you can deal so much damage to enemies that they die before this can even take effect. The drones are a little bit slow to actually get their abilities out. But yeah, they have a basic heal they can use, and they even have a sort of area of effect heal that can heal all enemies at once. And these aren't tiny heals, these can basically repair entire cannon shots all at once. So it is a good idea to get rid of them first. Now, they are stunned by machine guns, and honestly, machine guns are probably the best thing against them, since machine guns are very accurate. Drones have a high evasion rate, and so the machine guns kind of counteract to that. So let's go ahead, stun. Now get another cannon shot. Oh god, okay, he's gone. And now, this drone cannot do anything. We can sit here and defend. Sadly, Hack's hero mode has ended. But the drone can't do anything. Yeah, standby, nothing happens. So essentially, the drones can't do anything else. These swarm drones, all they can do is heal. Now as you see, yeah, if we try to hit it with a grenade, they do have a chance to miss, as just happened. And they missed again. So yeah, machine guns, pretty effective against drones and all that jazz. Chick, please hit him this time. Thank you, Chick. But the crew actually listened for once. They don't always do that. Alright then. That was a good fight. That was a really good fight, and now Malt is level 7. Good for him. I'm happy for you, Malt. Alright then. The children's great feeling will continue until the next intermission. You can enter hero mode multiple times by raising the mood in battle, so try to aim for that. Okay then. So yeah, that's hero mode. Very useful effects you get, and that's why it can be very important to get your intermissions done efficiently and fast. Now, if you're a little unsure of intermissions and how to deal with them, then I have done that last episode and sort of explained how to do them and do all the tasks. Now, with that selfless, shameless advertising aside, let's get into the next fight. Okay, then. So this is a big predicament and something the game likes to do. So the Zyklon here, it's a very tanky enemy. It has armor, a whole lot of hull, basically just a general nuisance and takes a long time to get rid of. So with the Yaghound or some of the other lower health enemies, you can get them out of the way before the drones can do anything. That can't be done with the Zyklon. So, the drones, maybe they can't repair its armor, but the actual hull, the HP of it, they can repair very quickly, and because it has so much of it, there's generally no way to get rid of it without the drones being gone first. So, these drones are gonna be a priority. And yeah, sadly, I keep checking this because I'm so used to having high-level characters. Kyle does get some nice anti-air unit abilities later on. Alright, there we go. Drone stunned. Now, what do we want to do with Chick? Could we pull off another stun grenade? That would be fabulous. Oh, yes, okay. So now he's going to be locked in there with his current turn time, and he can't really advance forward to do another attack. That's good. Okay, that's even better. How about we kill this drone right now? Perfect. And as you can see, Even though time has passed, the Zyklon still hasn't been able to do anything because he has that nasty shock effect. It's a really good effect to have on enemies. Now then, Hack's abilities. Oh yeah! So, Twin Sparks, this is a nice ability. It's a two-hit attack that may inflict burns on the enemy. So yeah, as I said, Hack is really good at just dishing out damage in general. And in this case, it's a bit of damage over time, since the fire effect basically will deal damage to the enemy every time they take a turn. Now, what about this other ability, Hot Blood, Temporary Luck Increase, which is critical rate. So this is a sort of self-buff ability, and it does take way less time to use than normal abilities. So see Twin Sparks up there on the top bar means that it will be after Kyle's turn before Hack gets to go again. But with Hot Blood, then Hack will actually get to go again before Kyle's turn is up. So these self-buff abilities in long-term engagements are good. If you have maybe some stuns on the enemy or the shock effect like we have and can get some prep time, these can be amazing in longer fights. But for short-term fights, you really shouldn't spend the time or the SP to really mess with them. Now, this is a Zyklon and kind of want to show this ability off, so let's go ahead and buff ourselves up. Alrighty then. So now Hack's critical rate is increased. Let's go ahead and hit the Zyklon. Okay. The shock effect has finally come off the Zyklon. So now, as you can see, Hack does have a sort of critical chance buff. So let's go ahead and try some Twin Sparks. Maybe get some flame going. That would be nice, wouldn't it? I think so. And it does actually happen. Good. Let's get some armor down. Perfect. And now let's get ourselves defended. And it was a good choice. He's doing the air blow. Yeah, not too bad. And of course, because he has the fire, he burns himself a little bit with that. So, overall, pretty good. Wow, yeah, that was a really big hit. And it probably did happen because of Hack's self-buff. Okay, then two more people leveled up. Ooh! New skill mastered, Sharp Arrow. Strong attack that ignores the enemy's armor. This is a very good ability, although sometimes it can be sort of a false positive because it ignores the enemy's armor, which is good, and that means that Kyle's DPS against the enemy can be really nice, but it doesn't actually remove the armor for everybody else. But in certain situations, and there are enemies who can repair their armor so fast that it's not even really worth it to try and get rid of the armor, and against those enemies, this is a very nice ability, and I'm happy to have it in my arsenal as soon as level 7. Good to know, and now Boron is level 7 as well. Despite not actually really participating in many of the fights, I mean, I suppose he's Chick's support, for now. Okay then. How can we save Mom and Dad? With this tank, the Taranis, we can surely do it. What should we do? Do you mind helping us? We won't ask you to do anything dangerous, of course. Oh, come on, Hannah. We're in a war. There is nothing about this that is not dangerous in some way. Okay, sure. Yay! We're just blindly leading children into war. How lovely. And of course, we're going to go the normal route, because remember, you get more experience and more power and rewards from the normal routes. And I'm actually going to put another rule on myself. Not only can we not eat food, not only do we have to starve ourselves to death, but I'm only going to be going the hardest routes. Not sure if I've mentioned this before, but yeah, it's a thing that I'm going to be doing. I also remember I kind of want to change my formation up just a tad. Yeah. Kyle, you are not going to be the machine gunner. I want to go ahead and use May. I also realize that this means we're using all dog children to fight. Yeah, we're just using puppies for war. I mean, that just sounds adorable. It's probably going to be adorable. Alright then. Yay, these guys are back. The Lothar. Yeah, apparently that's pronounced Lothar. Didn't know that when I first mentioned these guys. Well, as always, we're going to be getting rid of them, because I don't like getting stunned constantly. Getting spammed with stuns. Not a fan of that, believe it or not. There we go. Get rid of some of his armor. Just a little bit. And get him stunned. The Lawfer's going to do something. Do I want to... Well, here's the thing. This is a machine gunner, so they're probably the best to defend with since they have the least damage. Okay, then. Chick, hit him, please. Would have been nice if you killed him. I didn't specifically tell Chick to kill him, so I can't technically blame her. Hack, kill him. There you go, that's killing him. That's what we like to see. Alright, now it's just the Zyklon. Now, we are kind of at the point in this battle where... Because SP is such a valuable resource, you don't really want to use abilities all the time. So let's think about this. He has, like, 277 hull. He's already lost an armor point. His damage isn't that good because he's made to absorb damage, not really dish it out. And we have plenty of hit points left. So this is a time where you actually want to save on SP by not using abilities. Since he's already probably going to die before he can get another attack off, there's really no reason to just keep on wasting more resource on a battle we're already going to win. That is just a sort of little tip. I know not everyone likes to leave things up to chance, but I just prefer to save resources for when I'm in a really large amount of danger. Alright then, more level ups. And a whole lot of stuff. I mean, we like stuff. Everybody likes stuff. Speaking of stuff, we're about to get more of it. There we go, repair kits and energy cells. Okay. And now another battle. What do we fight this time? Oh yay, a drone and a tank. That's just lovely. Shoot the drone out. Get the tank stunned. Hack, could you consider killing him right here, right now? It would have been nice. How much hull do you have left? The Iron Fly has 69 hull, but the tank has even less, so we're going to use our machine gun on him. That way we're getting rid of the more dangerous damage dealer. Okay. Not the best, but we did get through. Of course, we do have another wave to go. Oh dear, what a pleasant little setup you've assembled. Yay, lots of healing, lots of damage. None of these things we like to take. At this point we just kind of need to get rid of these things first. Okay, I don't really feel like we're in the position to actually kill any of the tanks outright, so let's just keep trying to get rid of the drones. We sadly miss. Okay. We are going to take some big damage, aren't we? Yeah, let's just go ahead and bite the bullet. And watch as he doesn't bite the grenade. Okay. This is going to hurt. This is gonna hurt really bad! Ouch! Okay. Keep focusing down the drones, May. Thank you. Hack, could you hit him? No? Okay. I mean, it's a bit much to ask. 40% chance. Chick, how do you feel about hitting the drone? She feels great about hitting the drone right now. We're gonna need some healing soon. Like, really soon. Really good thing Chick has a little bit of that. Because this is gonna seriously hurt. Well, maybe not if one of them miss. But, you know, he has to go in, use the Cerberus shot. Okay. If the Taranis HP drops, the risk of status ailments for the children increases. However, if the children are in a tight spot, the chance for them to enter hero mode increases. Okay then. So the drone's probably gonna die soon anyway. Let's go ahead and do that. And then that. That gets... No, that doesn't get rid of the tank. I really wanted that to get rid of the tank entirely. Wow, yeah, and now he gets healed. Please kill that drone, May. Thank you. Please don't do anything nasty. Okay. That wasn't too nasty. We are gonna need some way of healing ourselves, though, at this point. It's a good thing... Ooh, dear! Oh, yeah! Chick's hero mode! Use skill without spending SP! Well, that sounds like a great time to heal ourselves. Literally just free healing. How could you say no? There we go. Shoot him up. Blow him up. Perfect. Not the cleanest fight in the world, but... Yeah, we got there in the end. Alright, more level ups. So, Malt is now level 8. More damage, more luck. Yeah, just big stat increases all around. Although, ooh, Chick got a new skill. Yeah, risky grenade. Attack that may inflict bad luck on an enemy. So what does bad luck do? Because it's not exactly the most explanatory thing. It sounds like maybe something that reduces the enemy's critical chance or general hit chance. What it actually does is, you know how they do have a chance to resist certain negative effects that they get hit with? You know, the burns, the shock, the smoke. They don't always get affected by it. Risky grenade increases their chance of actually getting the negative effects from abilities. So, yeah, it's a nice ability. I don't really use it as much as maybe I should. Alright then, so now we get treasure. What does the treasure entail? Blueprints, rough tools, oh yeah, stuff we need to actually upgrade facilities. Which we definitely need to do soon. Yes, one more round. Ooh, and we have ruins to explore. Ooh, that'll be fun to explain. Alright then, onward. We get some hit points back. Oh, that almost topped us off entirely, okay. So then, ooh, it's just a big swarm of drones. My favorite. Kyle, we kind of need you for just a moment. Now, Chick is still in hero mode. If you put her in reserve, it will save the hero mode for later. So, you can actually just save it up for when you need it most. Because right now, we're not really in the biggest danger. So, you can actually save that hero mode for when you get into a big, nasty situation. But for now, we just need machine guns. Copious amounts of machine guns. There we go. It would be a miracle if Kyle could actually hit something. Come on, just try it. Oh my god, okay, he actually hit something. Thank you, Hack. Also, I may have gotten Hack's and Kyle's name mixed up for a moment. Okay, Kyle, shoot this drone out. Thank you. That's very helpful of you. Alright then. Well, the game really liked that. And now Hannah is level 10. Perfect. We're finally in our first double-digit levels. Happy to see it. Alright then, now we've got a really big fight coming up. Three waves. Okay, well at least we're starting it off nice and simple. Okay then. Kinda wanna save Chick's hero mode. But we gotta kinda show them off properly, don't we? Yeah, kinda just has to be done. Alright then, go ahead, shoot him. Chick, you grenade him. And Hack, you just, you know, shoot him. Perfect. That looks like a dead hound to me. Alright, next group. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh, this game. Oh, this freaking game sometimes. So then, these are three laughers. All of them have the ability to stun you. So, the game likes to set up groups like these quite often. So, I feel like I should introduce you to this little thing that I call a riot roll. So, a riot roll is basically when the enemy keeps using the riot grenade over and over and over, thereby stunning you again and again and again and again. This is a really nasty thing to watch out for, because it can mean that you just have massive swaths of time where you just cannot respond to anything. So the best thing to do is focus them down one at a time, so you can eventually get them to stop constantly stunning you. Speaking of constantly stunning them, I mean, if we're gonna get to use these abilities for free, please stun him. Please, it would be so helpful. Thank you. Stunned, delayed, everything we like. Kyle, please destroy this.
Okay.
Oh no. It begins. The riot roll begins, doesn't it? Yep. Oh god. Okay. Okay. Thankfully that one missed. May, destroy him. His attempt to stun us offends me greatly. Okay. We should be able to get through this. Should be. No promises. Hack, please destroy him. Thank you. Thank you, Hack. Alright. May, you get the honor of finishing this guy out. Thank you, May. Very helpful. Oh no! New enemy to talk about! Hi there, Kragister, which I think means War Beast in German. Huge, formidable tank with strong attack and armor. Since its attack is high, prioritize actions to delay it by using the same color weapons as its clock-shaped weakness icon. So yeah, these things are absolute monsters to deal with. They deal a ton of damage. The only real saving grace about them is they have a very slow attack speed. When they fire their cannon or use any ability, it's going to be a very long time before they get to do that again. So yeah, this thing is a priority, and sadly he has the healer drones, so we can't really just try and focus him down immediately. Okay then. Do we want to use any abilities? Quick Assault. Yeah. With speed increase. See, that could be helpful right now. Problem is, that's going to eat up with a lot of SP. Let's just do some machine gunning to start. And, Chick, I know it's sadly going to cost us something right now, but we really, really need to get this guy stunned. Watch, when we need it most, it will not affect. And right as I say that, it doesn't actually affect. Okay, Hack, you need to delay him right now. Like, right now. Okay, good. That'll give Chick another chance to stun him. May, please, destroy him. That's not destroying him. Okay, Chick. Don't shag it up this time. Oh, he resisted again. Okay, brace, defend. He's gonna hit. Giga Claw, his most powerful ability, right off the bat. Ooh! That did not feel good. The drones aren't feeling too ecstatic about healing him, thankfully. Not sure why they're not healing him. He's most definitely injured. But, we'll try and take it. Okay, then. That's another delay for the drone. Ah, yep, he's gonna heal him. Not great. Oh, it's such massive chunks of health, too. It's never a tiny heal. Chick, please finish him out. Thank you. Sadly, now we're gonna have to defend. Not the best thing. Now, using a link attack right now, not joking around or anything, it would be kind of a good idea. It would be probably the best thing. However, you can save these up for the last boss of the said chapter, because they only actually completely zero out when you've finished the chapter. Until then, the link gauge between the characters will stay filled up until you actually use the link attack. So always save them up for absolutely dire situations, because it is very, very optimal to save them for the final boss of the chapter. So that is why I'm not using link attacks, for anybody curious, because I know it's probably really confusing. It's a super dangerous enemy, he's dealing tons of damage, but there's just gonna be more dangerous things down the road. A Twin Sparks wouldn't be the worst thing right now. Of course, is he just resistant to everything? He's resisted the shocks, now he's resisted the flame. Alright, here we go. Resist that. Absolute mountains of lead being shoved down your throat. Yeah, I can't really resist that, can you? Oh, yeah, that's a lot of damage we took. We still got a B, though. And a lot of level ups. Okay, then. Any new abilities? No, just stat increases, it seems. Alright, then. That is a lot of stuff we got. This is why you want to go down the harder routes, you get big stuff. Also, the B rank. That's such a pretty looking B rank. I always like the look of the ranks in this game. I don't know why, they're just pretty sometimes. Alright then. Now it's time for something completely different. Like meat! Alright then. Our first expedition. You found some mysterious ruins! In this world, ruins like these are hidden in various locations, and the children can be sent to explore them. By exploring the ruins, you can obtain various items, including materials, to expand facilities. Now, let's select yes to explore the ruins. Alright then, yes. You can choose up to 3 children at a time to explore the ruins. Children sent to explore will gain experience. Failing expedition will not result in children getting injured or a game over. Now, let's select the children and go exploring. Alright then, so yes, expeditions. So when you first come across an expedition, you notice it does show an action point cost. But right now that is 0 because it is the first time we found this expedition thing. So when you first find these, always do them, because you can always do these in the intermission, but then they will cost action points. So then, yeah, let's just select our expedition team. Now, as for who you actually select, I am not sure it actually affects anything. Like a Boron, you would think he would have a massive hitbox. I'm not entirely sure. But whoever does do the expedition will get experience. So let's go with Hannah, May, and Malt. Yeah, there we go. Go ahead and execute. It also shows in this little list here the potential items you can get, like potting soil for farming, pine wood and birch wood for upgrading the dormitory, I think? Come back to me on what the wood does. You can also get crystal dust, which is for upgrading the reactor, which gives you more SP. And also a wooden branch. Pretty sure you only use that for upgrading the fishing stand. But honestly, with how much we use that, that's not even really that bad of a deal. So then, let's execute. Alright then. You arrived at the ruins. Yes, I can see that game. You can obtain various items here, but watch out for traps and other dangerous monsters. If you fall into a dangerous situation, use your steam gun to overcome it. Yes, we have a steam gun. Remaining bullets for your steam gun are shown on the top left. Stock up on bullets so they don't run out. Children stuck in traps or attacked by monsters will become incapacitated and be replaced by another child. The expedition will end when all children are incapacitated, and you will automatically return to the Taranis. Hidden treasure chests in the ruins require a key. Try to obtain the treasure before finishing the expedition. So then, yes, once you're in the expedition, you can actually go back through the door and leave at any time. But, of course, we do have a treasure chest here, you know. Would be interesting to see what's in there. So then, yeah, what are these? These are, yes, the toy gun bullets. The toy gun. It definitely won't hit like a toy gun, I'm just saying. So these expeditions, they're sort of like these mini puzzles in a way. Each bullet you get is sort of like a key to unlock a certain thing, in a way. Is that making any sense? Probably not. But see this wall here? We can use our bullets to shoot them down. But remember, there is a very finite number of bullets in each dungeon. Oh yeah, and also monsters. Yeah, it's a good idea to shoot those before they hit you because they do incapacitate you. Alright then, crystal dust. Now then, there are going to be a lot of points in these expeditions where there are alternate rooms. Now, we do have the key over here, so we can actually right now go in, grab the chest, and end any other risk of ourselves. Because if we lose everyone before we get to the chest, then it ends the expedition, and then we miss out on the treasure chest. But also, if we go to the chest now, we miss out on any extra loot that may be hidden in here, like in this room up here. So, twin gun bullet, meat vase. And vase has pine wood. So, yeah, just keep that in mind, is that you usually, if it's not too dangerous, you want to finish out the expedition entirely before opening up the chest. So then, we have pretty much grabbed everything. Oh yeah, and also, it's really important to mention it at this point, but you can dash. Yeah, you can do a sort of sprint in this game to speed yourself up. Just so you know, and it's very important to remember for these expeditions, because that can get you out of so many situations. So then, let's open up this chest. Alright then. Expedition complete. And when it's all done, it'll tell you how many of the monsters you defeated, all your obtained treasure and items. Oh, and Vault leveled up. Alright then. And of course it'll show you all the items you obtained, just like it would after a battle or something like that. Now, keep in mind, the results here, unlike the normal ranking, this is basically a percentage of how much of it you cleared. So the monsters defeated, there was only one there, and so it automatically gives you 100. So if you missed anything, then it won't reach that magic number of 100, thereby making it harder to get the S rank. So yeah, do keep that in mind, because the S rank gives you that nice experience multiplier of 1.5, thereby meaning that you get even more experience from these. So it really is incredibly advantageous to clear out the entire expedition before you go. So then, yeah, that's our first expedition. Now keep in mind, these are essentially going to be a tad bit of a mainstay. They're going to be sort of what I do in the intermissions quite often. So then, first expedition done. Items obtained through exploring ruins can be used to expand facilities. There are various benefits to be obtained, so let's level up the facilities that can be expanded. Yes, and that's, I'm sure, what we're going to be doing at the next intermission. Alright then, onward. Ooh, I see some real nasty business up ahead. Thankfully, it'll be a moment before we get to that. Oh yes, Dale's Berman Frontline Camp. Meanwhile, in a Berman camp, two old generals had been warned of the Taranis' approach. Oh, hello there, gentlemen. Isn't this interesting? The tank that defeated Pretzel. He must have underestimated those Gasco country bumpkins and their ability to put up a fight. Why don't we play a little game? To see which one of us can obliterate that tank, my old friend. Why not? It does sound more fun than competing over how many houses we can crush. Alright then, yes, Baum and Stollen. That is how I pronounce that. I'm sure it's meant to be pronounced Stollen or something. I just pronounce it Stollen because it sounds funny to me. Alright then, it is now possible to expand facilities. Expand them from each facility menu. Okay then. You can find items you need to expand the facilities in the ruins. Yes, I'm sure we'll be doing that just a bit. It is now possible to select expedition from the observation room. By using AP, you can explore all the ruins which you have discovered so far. Alright then. Oh dear. So, that is a lot of tasks. Want to play with Cluckins on the farm? Hannah wants to cook in the mess room, very sorry about that. Kyle wants to sleep. Just tough it out, walk it off. Socks wants to go on a guys-only expedition. We might get around to that. So then, yeah. We can get some of these done. We can get some of these done. Most particularly doing things in the farm. That is always going to be done first. Although facilities can be expanded. And yes, new runes have been added to the observation room. Thank you very much. Oh, and there's our harvest results. Alrighty then. Now then, why don't we expand the workshop? Doesn't that sound fun? Doesn't that sound neat to be able to continue upgrading and get even stronger? I think that sounds really jazzy. So this will increase our highest upgradable level on all of our components to 5. So we are immediately going to do that. So yes, expand the workshop. Alright then, the workshop has been expanded. Okay then, so next time we want to upgrade the workshop, we're going to need blueprints, basic tools, and metal plates. Yeah, we should be getting more metal plates soon. But for now, we have everything we need to upgrade. Quite a few things, in fact. Like the armor. Yes, please. We like armor. We want another 500 hit points. We will need them desperately. Thank you for helping out, May. Alright then. Upgrading was successful. Good to hear. Okay, so next time we're gonna need even more metal plates and actually more iron scraps. I thought we had a really good supply of iron scraps. Silly me. Alright then, reactor upgrade. Yep, let's get this done. It'll eat up all our crystal dust, but it'll take our SP to 74. So go ahead, get it upgraded. Thank you for helping, chick. Because yes, sadly, we are going to get lower and lower in our success rate as we keep doing these. Okay then. Ooh, Hannah's now level 11. Goody goody. Alright then. Now, last thing we can upgrade is the grenade launcher. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. It was successful, right? Yes, good, okay. And that's even more experience, and a stronger grenade launcher. So yeah, now we can actually upgrade things again. Feels very nice. Now then, let's go ahead and deal with our farm stuff, because in the notebook, that's not what I'm looking for. In the notebook, yeah, so Malt wants to play with Cluckin' on the farm, and Chick wants to plant something on the farm. So yeah, we can do both of those quite easily. Now, I'm not going to eat food, but someone mentioned that, you know, I should actually sort of show the food off and how it benefits you. So I'm not actually going to cook anything, but I will kind of show off what each of these do. So they do increase your stats basically by a certain percentage. Sadly, in Fuga 1, they don't actually show the exact percentage, but rest assured, it does go up if you keep expanding the facility to cook things. So, yeah, baked potatoes increases your luck, critical rate. Steak fries just increases your attack. Tomato juice! Yummy tomato juice! Oh yeah, I'm real excited to eat that. But it does decrease your skill cost. Now, the skill cost decreases are perhaps some of the most powerful, especially later on. Because it doesn't seem like much, it's only like one less SP. But as you use more and more abilities, and as fights start getting longer and longer, further and further into the game, it can save you dozens of points of SP. So it's definitely good. And now, for the best food in the entire game. Bread. Yes, it takes wheat and eggs, but it increases the experience acquired in battle and increases affinity acquired in battle. Mostly, you want this for the experience, because by continuing to gain more and more experience, it means that you will continue to always outpace the enemies and stay stronger than them, and you'll get even stronger than them as things keep going on, if you continue to eat this every intermission. And honestly, if you want to give yourself the best chances of getting through the game and not getting softlocked in some way because you're just too weak to fight something, eating bread is a wonderful way to make sure that that doesn't happen. And as you upgrade it, they will get, you know, different names, they will be different meals, but they will do the same things just by a greater magnitude. So yeah, that is what food is like. And fun fact, it has a 100% success rate. And I'm pretty sure food usually has a 100% success rate. It's not like an upgrade which can outright fail. Actually, I think you can fail cooking. There's just a really weird case scenario that doesn't happen all that often. Although we haven't failed an upgrade yet either. So, oh yeah, we can expand the farm as well. Or at least, oh yeah. So when you're upgrading the farm, there is a lot of different menus. Oh my goodness. So let's just make sure we're on the starting menu. Yeah, so the farm itself, upgrading this section of the farm will increase the number of plots you have, meaning how many different things you can actually be growing on the farm all at once. The garden part of it, the crop's max capacity, this basically means that when you grow a certain crop there, you will get more of that. Yeah, increases how many crops can be harvested. So this means that if we were to grow something like, you know, potatoes, the most glorious vegetable, obviously, if we were to grow those, we would get two of them per harvest rather than one. So it means that for each slot that would be taken up in the normal farm by potatoes, upgrading this will increase how many potatoes we actually harvest. So if we were to, say, take up two of the farming plots with potatoes, rather than getting two, we would then get four. Now, the next part of it is the coop. Basically, this is the same as the garden side of it, but it works for the things like cluckins and the moo sheep. You know, things like that. And it is what we can upgrade. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's even worse. The coop and the pen are actually two separate things. So, yeah, you upgrade the cluckins and the moo sheep separately. My god, yeah, I forgot about that. They really don't make the farm really easy to deal with in this one, do they? Yeah. Let's go ahead and upgrade the, yeah, these both take pine wood. Let's do the cluckin first. Alright then, so now the coop is expanded. It has been upgraded. So then, oh, and to continue upgrading it, now we're going to need the birch wood. Okay then. So then, let's actually plant some things. So yeah, now that we've upgraded the coop, these cluckin, yeah, they're level 2 and will be a bit more effective. Let's also do some moose sheep and, let's do potatoes. Potatoes deserve more love. Like, people just, they don't appreciate potatoes the way that potatoes actually deserve to be loved. Potatoes are like, they're like some of the best food in the world. And people just don't get it. Alright then, Malt feels great because he wanted to play with Cluckin on the farm. And Chick feels great because she wanted to plant something, anything, on the farm. Alright then. So, notebook. Anything else we can do easily? Oh yeah. So Socks wants to go on a guys only expedition. Let's go ahead and do that. But first, let's talk to May because she also wants to just talk to somebody. Hey there, May. Here to ruin your childhood again. Why did they break everyone's village? They probably weren't doing it on purpose. It's just one of those, you know, in war, sometimes you get some collateral damage. And they probably just ran to a situation where it was easier to just shoot down the houses than actually, you know, try not damaging them. Because it's not like it's the Burmans' houses. It's not like they're actually gonna have to come back and repair anything. Oh yeah, wait a minute. Ooh, yes, roof. Have we even been to the roof? Well, just in case we haven't, yes, we have a roof that had a rusty cartridge on it for some reason. It also has a boron up here. Pretty interesting feature for your roof, all things considered. Alright then, so then, what is this guy's expedition thing all about? Yes, this is the observation room. You can obtain stage information by observing the surroundings. Selecting expedition will send children to search for treasure in the ruins. Yes, that's what we're about to do. We may as well observe. Anna, what do you see? So, gained information on the surroundings. Basenji wetlands. Wastelands. Wastelands. Not wetlands. A wide wasteland in the northeast of Dale. With sparse vegetation, this area is largely untouched by civilization. Resource surveys have yet to be conducted here since there is little demand for it. Okay. What a sad little area. Now, fun fact, you can get an achievement. At least I know there's an achievement here on Xbox. I'm not sure if it's the same for PlayStation or Steam or things like that. But yeah, you can actually get an achievement for observing, I think it's about 30 different locations. It was the last achievement I got before I 100%ed the game. The observe thing, that was the last achievement. It's kind of ridiculous. Anyway, yes, first select the ruins to explore. When new ruins are discovered along a route, they will be added here. Better items can be found in higher level ruins, but the difficulty will also be higher. Alright then. So, we are heading to the Shrine of the Forest God. You can choose up to 3 children at a time to explore the ruins. Children sent to explore will gain experience. Yes, we have slightly covered this just a moment ago. Failing an expedition will, yes, not result in the children getting injured or game over. Yes. We are vaguely aware of such things. It's definitely not like we talked about this about 20 minutes ago. Alright then. So, how do we do this guy's only expedition? Well, basically, it means you only need to do the expedition with the male characters. Now, of course, unlike a lot of other things, the character who actually wants it needs to be involved. So, Kyle, you can lead. Sox, because he needs to be involved. And let's go Malt. He's just a nice cherry on top. Alright then. Execute. Now then, despite this being the same expedition technically, they do randomize things a little bit. Like, they have different setups. Now, this is a sort of trap, this thing. If you're under it when it goes down, it will crush you, which incapacitates you, believe it or not. Now, you do have the option to attack these, which temporarily disables them. Don't do it, because you are always going to need the bullets for something far more important. It is actually not that difficult to just sort of wait for them to be up and then get through quickly. So, yeah, it gives you the prompt to attack. Don't do it. Save the bullets for something else. Like monsters. That's a far better use of your bullets. So that's more crystal dust. And over here we have potting soil and a key. Now then, there we go, some pine wood. And hey, what do you know? This last bullet actually needed to be used on the vase in order to get its treasures. And fun fact, even when you shoot these traps, they don't go off permanently. They will only be disabled for a set amount of time. So it is really, really not worth it to try disabling them. So then, let's open up that chest. What do we get? Oh, we got some wooden branches. Okay. Well, I'm sure the scrap fishing will love that. So all the monsters gone, all the items obtained, all the treasure. And hey, Kyle got a fat level up. A fat level up? Yeah, Kyle got a fat level up. We got a body positivity level up. Yeah, that's what happened. So now Sox feels great. He got his guide's only expedition. Perfect. Okay then. Now, I know we just got things helpful for scrap fishing. In fact, this is something I should do more often, and I sometimes fail to do it. Because there are often items hidden around all over the tank, then it's actually a good idea to just go through and see what you can get, find just lying around. By the way, there's a farm upgrade available. Oh yeah, because we got more pine wood. Because we just did an expedition, right? Yeah, okay, sure. Upgrade that pen. Okay then, pen has been expanded. Nice. So then, let's go to the scrap fishing. Because it's me we're talking about. I can't think of any other way to finish an expedition. Oh no, we can't expand it yet? Oh! And it's all my fault. We had pine wood. Yeah, just a moment ago we had pine wood. Now we don't, because I used it to upgrade the pen. Oh! Yeah, that's a thing that can happen. That's something that you should watch out for. Oh, yeah, that kind of... Ooh! That hurts. That really shaggin' hurts. That... It does. Oof. Okay. Oof. That's just... Oof! You know what? No. We're not going to go scrap fishing. I'm going to do another shagging expedition. I'm gonna get my pine wood. I'm gonna upgrade that fishing for next time. I demand to have better fishing. This is not a negotiation, Fuga. Do you hear me? This is not up for debate. I will have an upgraded fishing, or I will die trying. Okay, then. So, here, it seems to have chosen the first setup. Yes, it has. So, yeah, if you do the expeditions since if you do the not talking correctly, then you can eventually get used to it. Don't get used to not talking correctly. Do get used to these expeditions, because this is the first setup that we had when it did the expedition tutorial. And keep in mind, it does do that quite often, because there's only a certain amount of setups and configurations that each expedition has. So then, we already know that we've gotten everything in here. Later on, these expeditions will get far more complicated. They'll add a whole slew of new mechanics to deal with. Yeah, it won't be so simple later on. Alright then, Mei is now level 9. Woo, encourage. Speed increase on all allies. That is actually a decent ability. I kind of sometimes wish it didn't cost SP. I think that would make it potentially overpowered, but right now it's not that useful. But keep in mind, Mei does technically have the lowest DPS, even if she has the best attack speed. So sometimes making it so all those other turns come quicker can be quite effective. And oh no. They gone and done it. They finally gone and done it. Yep, I knew they would. I knew they would. So we can upgrade if we had the action points for it, because we just did the expedition, which meant we got whatever items were needed, probably the crystal dust. But now we don't have any action points to do anything about it. Okay, but we can finally upgrade our scrap fishing, because now we have the pine wood for it. And we have two wooden branches. Well, we don't really need one of them at this point. Alright then, more scrap fishing. But of course, we can't actually interact with it yet because, yep, not enough action points. Man, that's a classic. Well, how do we use this last action point? Let's talk to Kyle. That seems like a productive use of our time. Sigh. Oh joy. More noisy kids. Yeah. Yeah. Very glad that that's how I used that last action point. Very, very glad. Onward. Now then, we are going to start fighting some very, very intense enemies. This chapter is sort of the, it's kind of the intelligence check. This is basically the chapter that makes sure you can properly play the game. If you don't have the proper, like, triple digit IQ to get through the game, then it's going to be seen right here, or at least double digit IQ. If it's below double digit, this is probably where everything is going to come falling apart for most people. Because I'm not sure, but here on Xbox, they actually do track what percentage of the people who played the game got each achievement. And there is an achievement for getting through each chapter. And I'm pretty sure you see a major drop-off at this point in the game. Because this is where it finally starts getting absolutely no nonsense. So this is considered a elite battle. So basically it means that the enemies that are here are going to be absolutely insane. They're just going to be so much harder than anything we've faced up until this point. And of course we're fighting it with like a quarter of our SP. Yay! I'm so excited. So then, get his armor down first things first. But more importantly, we really need to get rid of these Yaghounds because they're going to produce way more damage than the Zyklon. Please kill it, chick. Thank you. Thank you. That is a very, very good thing. What's not so good is he's using an air blow. Ow. Okay, it's not a disaster yet. We're still doing kind of good. Focus fire on the Yaghound. Just get his damage out of the equation. Good. Okay. Now it's just the Zyklon, and the Zyklon doesn't have as much damage as other enemies, and so we should be pretty dang good to get through. At least this first wave. Remember, we have two other waves after all this. Okay, so go ahead, defend. Okay, good. Not too terrible. I say that we took like 200 damage, but that's, you know, for Fuga, that's not actually that bad of a hit to just casually take. Oh dear, double Zyklons. What joy. Go ahead, get that piercing shot out. Yeah, go ahead, just focus these guys down one at a time until they finally fall over. Well, I say fall over, explode. Okay, please tell me he dies like this round. Yeah, he's definitely gonna go down. Good. Good. Defend. Oh, okay, I'm glad I defended. I considered taking his armor down a bit. Would have been pretty bad. But, you know, I'm just psychic. It's crazy Kitsune Gaming. You just need to be ready for these things. Gotta be ready for some magic to happen. There we go. We're getting him down, we're getting him down. How much health do you have left? 82. I think a grenade... How about now? A grenade can finish you off. Perfect. Good. Good, good. Now we're gonna see something absolutely crazy. Hello, everybody! Brand new enemy to talk about. Yaghound Mark 3. We haven't even seen the Mark 2 of these things yet, but yeah, let's just talk about the Mark 3. The strongest and latest model in the Yaghound series. When half of its HP is depleted, it enters a dangerous state of wrath with increased attack. Defeat it quickly. Well, see, that's easier said than done. What is the normal Yaghound hull points? About 367. That's the average Yaghound. This guy is walking in here with, oh, 2,000. 2,000 hit points. That's honestly, I mean, how many did Colonel Pretzel have? He has, I remember, Colonel Pretzel, the first boss of the game, he was the tutorial boss, but he could heal himself. He had about 1,800 hit points. This guy has 2,000. Yeah, and he's gonna produce way more damage than Pretzel could ever dream of. Yeah, it's getting a little intense. Still, let's get rid of the Yaghounds first. And see what sort of position we're in after that. It would be amazing if we could get a stun on this guy. Oh, please, chick. Please. Please. Thank you. Ouch. Also out. Oh, and May is afraid. Yay! So now we have only 80% accuracy, despite May being a machine gunner. Joy, joy. Still, though, we should be able to kill these things. Okay, he's staying stunned there for quite a while. Chick, please kill him. Thank you. Oh, this stun's probably gonna wear off pretty soon. Yep!
brace yourselves! Oh, that very nearly ended our whole career. Ah, how do we really try and recover from that?
Hack, go ahead and cannon them.
May, machine gun them.
Chick, heal. You can't miss a heal. So even though you're scared right now, you can still heal without any issue. May, defend. Oh god, another angry fang. Please stop. Please, no, calm down. Calm down! Cannon? Now keep in mind, once he goes down to half health, he is gonna start getting some crazy damage output. So we really, really need to heal. Ooh! May switch to hero mode, double speed. That's great, because Hannah is supporting her. So that's gonna be a lot of hit points we get back. Good. Very good. Spend skills without... Use skills without using s- H... What? Bleh. Use skill without spending SP. Chick's hero mode. That is exactly what we need right now. Lullaby! Right now. Right now. No negotiation. Right now. Oh dear goodness. Oh, the insanity begins. So he now has Wrath, and, he missed. Well, that's a little awkward. Okay then, let's capitalize on that. I'm kind of really glad he didn't hit, because that could have been just world-ending. Okay, there we go. Ah, that was a quick hero mode. Please die in the next cannon hit. Do we even have SP to... Oh, we don't even have SP for Twin Sparks. Okay, just cannon him. Good. He's gone. Oh god, okay, yeah. Welcome to Fuga. We have officially entered the game. At least we got a whole ton of experience for that. Alright then, Malt's level 10. Hannah's level 12 already. Boron's level 9. Ooh, Sock's got Burning Spirit. Temporary luck increase on all allies. So, yeah. This one isn't a self-buff. This applies to everybody. It's a very good skill if you have Socks in your lineup. We don't right now because we're showing off Hack and Chick, but yeah, that's gonna be real helpful later on. Thank you, game. Infinity has increased and improved support effects, so more attack, more skill damage, good. Oh boy. Good thing is we're going to get some major recovery after all that. Thank you very much. Now we get some more items, and we got our first bit of steel. Oh yeah, we're going to need to use a lot of steel. I mean, they call it Melodies of Steel. You would figure steel would be involved in some way. You're coming up on a Burman camp. Be careful. Ah, we'll be as careful as we can be. We'll get to where those good guys took Mom and Dad soon, right? Do we really have to fight again? Come on, Boron, you're a big guy. You can handle it. You are so small, yet so brave. Okay, Hack, bring it on. Alright then. Now some more dangerous routes. My favorite. Definitely not gonna crush us. Right, dangerous route, right? Yeah, you're just doing the Yag Hound thing. Perfect. Yeah, we can kill him before the drones get involved, I hope. Don't you love how certain I sound? We can kill him before the drones heal him, I hope. There we go. No SP cost, no SP cost. Good. So now these drones can just sit here and sputter. Sadly, it's probably going to use up the last of Chick's hero mode. But that's alright. Don't really need it. It saved us in the dangerous situation. So now we can go into another dangerous situation and need it even more here. That's probably what's going to happen, I bet. Knowing my luck, anyway. So yeah, the drones, they just can't do anything. once they have no one to heal, then that's just their assistance in the battle is essentially over. Okay, then. Now we play the triple Zyklon game. Oh, love this game. So, not sure if we've ran into this before, but this is a thing that the game likes doing where they just plop three Zyklons into your lap, and they just say, deal with it. So essentially, this is sort of a trick. What the game wants you to do, and how you can really mess up any encounter like this, is by spreading your damage evenly across all three. But keep in mind, Zyklons are designed all around staying alive, not really dealing ridiculous damage immediately. But if you spread your damage across all three of them evenly, it's going to take a really long time, and their damage with three of them will add up. So what you want to do is pick one and just focus them down immediately. So that is exactly what I plan to do. So we're going to use a piercing shot on him specifically. And then we want to use something like Twin Sparks on this one again. Now keep in mind, if you have Boron in your lineup, not really going to do that. Otherwise, we're not really showing off the new characters the way I want to. But if you have Boron in the lineup, or just any cannon user with a area of effect attack, that's fabulous for these groups. Because then you're hitting everyone, which isn't necessarily good, but since you're doing it with a cannon, then it stuns all of them, thereby meaning that their chip damage becomes reduced dramatically. Alright then. So, that's one down. This now means that we are in a much better position. Okay then, what do we want to do next? I guess just grenade attack them. You know, I love how their little gun rings spin around. It just looks so cute. It gives them nice movement that makes them feel so alive. They're not gonna be alive pretty soon, but you know, right now, because of that whole gun spin, they do feel that way. Okay, he's gonna do an air blow. That is unfortunate. We could have defended against that. We didn't. Already regret it. But now we can focus down this guy. Okay, this time we'll defend. Good thing, because he was about to drop another air blow, but now it's thankfully well defended against. Goody goody. Grenade attack. Now defend again. Okay, he just uses a normal cannon attack. I'm not even sure what this weapon would be called, the gun ring that they use. Is it a machine gun? Is it... They look like baby cannons. They're definitely not machine guns, they're just baby cannons that go along the entire body. It's so weird. So weird. But thankfully, we're just about done with this group. Just about. Problem is, we gotta have another group after this, so... We're not out of the woods yet. Yeah, no, we're not remotely out of this. Ooh dear, okay. Don't do anything too nasty. Good. Okay. So then, what does the final wave present us? Oh no. Oh no, we're pretty much gonna have to use a link attack here pretty soon. Zyklon Mark 3. Again, we haven't even seen the Mark 2. Let's just plop a Mark 3 right in front of us like it's nothing. Latest muscle model with a skill to restore its armor rank. When half its HP is depleted, it will enter a state of wrath with increased attack, making it dangerous. Defeat it quickly. Yeah, again, with a Zyklon. Easier said than done. Yeah, 5 armor rank and 3,000 hit points. And it has the ability to restore 2 armor rank at a time. Yeah, these things are insane. Absolutely ridiculous. How do we even want to begin dealing with this? Get the drones out, because there's no way we're killing the Zyklon before the drones can do something. I guess try and get... No, I want to save up and try and stun the Zyklon. Like, with a full-on shock. Can we do that? Are you in the mood, chick? Please be in the mood. Thank you so much. Okay, that gives us some time to deal with the drones. Yeah, they're gonna heal them up, but we're not really focusing on the damage. Not right now, we just want to get the drones out of the fight. We want them to not be involved. In fact, Kyle, get your tail over here. We really need these drones gone, and we need them to be gone soon, or we're going to die. Thank you, chick. Okay, they're just gonna keep standing by because there's nothing they can do. Good. Okay. Okay, the Zyklon is now active again. Oh, brace your bumholes. Ouch. Okay. Not great. Would it be worth it to do another stun? Yes, I think so. We are officially in desperation mode, by the way. Okay, so he is stunned. That's good. That's great, even. Stun him again. Okay. Right now, there's really nothing we can do except for doing a piercing shot. That's all we have the SP left to do. We may have to use repair kits or energy cells or some of those jazzy bits of business. Not too sure. Yes, confirm this setup. Alright. Get him stunned. Oh god, he recovered from the electricity already. Leave it at 1, because kind of like Pretzel's armor repair, these guys don't tend to do it if they only have 1 bit of armor damaged, since they don't want to waste their turns on healing something that's barely damaged at all. It's gonna mean it takes him a long time to die, though. Yeah, we're still gonna have to use a link attack. It's pretty much inevitable. Oh, steel tornado. Ow. Oh no, May's depressed. Not the depression. Already, game. Already, you're gonna hit us with that. So, depression, it's a funny little thing. Kind of like in real life, depression can be absolutely deadly. See, what it does is it means that we can't use link attacks, even if they're fully charged, and we can't use skills. So, yeah, we're in crisis mode. We're gonna have to use the link attacks. Like, imminently. Yeah, confirm this setup. We can't heal ourselves. Yeah, we just need to hope that we can last a bit longer. And maybe I should have put him in a machine gunner so that when we use the link attacks, it does more damage. Because the armor defends against link attacks super effectively. Grenade. It was a critical. Barely budged his health bar, but you know, it was a critical. Another cannon. Good, good. Okay, we can change the formation again. And I need a machine gunner. Any machine gunner that isn't depressed. So, not May. Okay. Now then. Hack, get him stunned. Make it a big stun, please. That wasn't big enough. Okay, defend. Piercing shot. Please do not instantly repair your armor after this. I would be somewhat disappointed if you did that. Okay. That's not good either, but stop repairing the armor. So you technically did what I asked. No. Oh, Hannah's depressed. Oh, God. Yeah, this is what being under half health can do to you. So we're just gonna have to link attack right now. There we go. Wow. I'm astonished. I just feel so defeated right now. That did nothing. He didn't care. The Zyklon's just sitting there like, yeah, go ahead. Feed me more. Oh, and he's gonna go into Wrath soon. Yeah, we're gonna have to resort to using items. This is really bad. I don't know what I have done wrong. This is horrible. You should not be in this position whatsoever. Not another steel tornado. No, not another. You really pulled out another.
Oh, we have our first injury too. Everything's going so well. It's going so well, everybody. It's going amazing. Chick, you're not depressed yet. You will be soon at the rate we're going. Yeah. This is terrible. Yeah, we're gonna have to go ahead and use an energy cell. God, I hate myself right now. I hate myself for letting me fall this low. That felt bad. I just died on the inside just a tiny bit, believe it or not. Yeah. Yeah. We really need some twin sparks since we actually have the SP to do that again. Please. Thank you. Get his armor down. We're gonna have to heal ourselves again. Oh, at least his armor is almost gone. This is almost a little harder than the boss, even. I mean, the boss is gonna be absolutely ridiculous, but I mean... This is not easy. Okay. Piercing shot. There you go. His armor is gone. He's going to enter Wrath. Now, entering Wrath, fun fact, triggers the flames again. So now, it's gonna do it again. So yeah, keep that in mind. When they enter Wrath, that counts as a separate action. They do it immediately, it doesn't take them any time, but in the game's code, it counts as enough to trigger the flame. So, flames can be absolutely devastating to most Mark III enemies. Because any Mark III enemy, a Mark III to Mark II enemies, will have this wrath effect. So it means that flames are even more effective on them once they go to that half-health state. Okay, can we please finish this out? This has been such an embarrassing fight. Oh, this has been a shite show of epic proportions. Oh, that took so long, we took so much damage. But the technique was on point, apparently. Okay. Well, at least we got a lot of rewards and experience. That was an absolutely traumatizing battle, but we survived. Not sure if we're gonna survive the next one, though. But hey, a link event can be triggered. Cool. I have to remember that. Oh... God, it's only gonna get worse now. Oh, look at that, we're so close to an intermission. No, don't do this. It's gotta be done. I made the rules. Would love to just run away and go down the normal route, but nope. At least they're starting off nice and gentle. Well, as gentle as drones can be. Even though Mei is depressed, we can still use her normal attacks, so go ahead and do that for now. Or Hack can just hit him. Okay, sure. I mean, that works. It usually doesn't. Okay, then. Get rid of the drone. Hack, do you feel like pulling off another miracle shot? No. Everyone has their limits. Oh no, another one of these. Another Yaghound Mark III. Yeah, it's gotta be done. I hate it so much. Because you really should be saving these up for bosses as much as possible. Okay. Yeah, just machine gun the drones. This is just dreadful. This really is the point where the game says, hey buddy, it's time to wake up and start getting smart. Yeah, I guess just try and hit the full health drone with the cannon. Nope. Not today. Not this time. Ouch. At least the tank down there is being somewhat gentle. For now. He'll go crazy later. Okay.
Get rid of him. I guess defend with Hack, since he's probably not going to hit the drone. Well, it was a miss anyway, so... He kind of retroactively made my defend useless by missing. He specifically missed to make me feel like an idiot. I mean, that's a strategy right there. Okay. Yeah, Kyle first, since May is just absolutely depressed. She is one sad puppy right now. Okay then. Please, stun grenade. Please, please, stun grenade. Thank you. That's what we need. Not gonna set any flames on him yet with Hack. We're gonna wait until he's a bit lower. There we go. Lots of damage. Now we can go ahead and set flames on him. So defend. Twin sparks. This should be absolutely career ending for him. So, yep, he enters Wrath. Takes tons of damage. Oh no, he's gonna get his own before dying. Ouch. But thankfully the flame gets rid of him. Wow. Oh, any semblance of kindness has just been drained from the game. It's all gone. Where did it go? Yeah, I guess start working on the Zyklon 3's armor. It's gonna take a hot minute, but there we go. Actually, we should focus on the Hound first. Who doesn't get stunned? That's amazing. That's fabulous. I didn't want him to get stunned. Oh, and we took exactly 444 damage. The game is just telling us we're going to die at this point. Stop! It's not funny. Okay, so Kyle has been knocked out. At least he didn't die, but yeah. When they're knocked out, once they get injured, then the next time they get injured, they're just knocked out entirely. So now we can't use them. This is just a bloody fine situation. Sox? I know we haven't really used you much, but we're desperate at this point. We're just absolutely desperate. Yeah, it's gonna have to be repair kits and energy cells. I hate using these so much, but do we really have much of a choice? We do have a choice. We can just sit here and die, like absolute muffins. Okay. Defend. Oh no, we were trying to get ourselves back up. That's gonna make that so much harder. Now we're gonna have to defend again, because now the Zyklon's doing things. Yay, May is afraid! Okay, thank you, Chick. That is exactly what we need. Yeah, the hero modes have been a lifesaver, that's for sure. Mostly just because I've played this so freaking terribly. Just doing that to get the Zyklon stunned. There we go, he's stunned. Chick, please... apply the stun this time. We need the stun. The stun is love, the stun is life. Just ask the Loffers. They don't do anything except for stun. Okay. Please, thank you. Lullaby. Lullaby, right now. Right now. Okay. Oh no, that's gonna get him to the Wrath? No, it doesn't. Oh, Hack is depressed. That was my one... No, this was my one escape plan. We're gonna have to use every resource now. Oh, that's ridiculous. Yeah, there's really not a whole lot we can do. I guess use the smoke ammo, maybe inflict smoke on the enemy. I mean, it's 100% chance if we hit. We really could use that on the Hound. Okay, we're already using ammos. Heal, right now. Oh, we're gonna need to defend. Oh, wait, no. Double speed, okay. Well, you're getting a double speed with your defending. How about that? Well, we're going to miss out on getting a lot of burn damage on him. Yeah, because he has Enter's Wrath already. But at least he missed. At least he missed. Not that we could have even really burned him, because we're depressed right now. God! Honestly, nothing but stuns and heals right now. We gotta make as much use of that hero mode. Okay. So that's probably, hopefully, going to be his last attack, I think. I have no confidence left. That stung. Okay. Let's start finishing off this fight. We're not even really finishing it. It's barely just begun. All this time and we're just trying to get the freaking hound down. Barely did it. Of course we... Oh, but Kyle's already knocked out, so we just don't have any more access to piercing abilities. Isn't that so fun? Isn't depression so fun to deal with? Ouch. Oh, Hack is... No, this isn't the time to panic, Hack. There is no room left for panicking. The panic needs to stay in a box somewhere. Okay, I guess we're just gonna have to drill him down. Maybe... use a, Oh, what am I looking for? I'm just so devastated. And now we're missing. Oh, okay. We need to use a stun grenade on him. That should maybe reduce his damage over time. Hopefully. Please? No. No. The game's just gonna tell me to go shag myself. Okay, at least he missed. So we miss with our effects, he misses with the cannon, that's fine. Heck, I really need you to delay him. Now we defend with Mei. Try to get the stun grenade with Chick. Please get the stun off. Thank you. So that is some time that he can just sit there and watch himself take damage. Good. Oh, look at how tanky these boys are. These are some beefy boys. And they're getting us below half health again. May, I need you to defend. Hack, please just kill him. No, why won't he die? Why won't he die? Stun him. Oh my god, he resisted. Stop resisting things! I can't handle it right now. Oh, we don't have enough left for stun grenade. Well, that's just cheery. We may have to use even more resource now. That's terrible. Okay, now the good thing is the Wrath effect will go away after a while. But until then, he's just gonna be absolutely world-ending. There's really no point in using items right now. We can't reduce his armor. That's the problem. All of our ability to get rid of armor is just gone. It just went out the window. It's either depressed or injured. Okay, he's down to his last quarter, I think. He has like three... Oh, God, no. He's down to his last third, more like. Oh, please go down. Please go down. Please, please, please. I beg you. I beg you. Oh, he's not going down. He's just not dying. I'm sorry, Chick. We can't get your mommy and daddy right now. We're too busy dying. Okay, Chick, if you're so scared, just defend, since at least that isn't affected by the fear. Oh, now Mei is injured. Oh, how much does he have left? Are we gonna have to use another resource kit? It's quite likely. Quite likely. At least Mei can shoot so freaking fast. Defend. Yeah, if he gets another turn, we're just gonna have to heal. Thankfully, he might not. Come on, guys, let's finish this out, please. Hack, you still have 100% hit chance, right? Good. He's still alive. After all that, we need to use one more. Because that machine gun cannot get rid of 49 health, not with 4 points of armor. This has been dreadful. This is a great way. What I've been doing this episode, I'm not bad at the game, I'm really not. I'm just trying to show you how to not play the game is the thing. That's what I was doing. That's the big secret. You've been deceived this entire episode. 106 turns. Wow. Oh wow, everyone leveled up. Oh nice, bravery. Temporary attack increase. So that's another self-buff that helps in long-term fights. This makes me realize maybe I should have used one of the self-buff abilities there. Yay, Kyle leveled up. You're knocked out and nearly dead, but you know, hey, you leveled up. Good for you, buddy. Boron leveled up. Sox leveled up. He gets 1 point of speed. I swear, speed is like the slowest stat to level up. Ooh. There we go. Hacks. Probably his best ability. Burning trigger. Attack on an enemy and damage increase with consecutive use. A max of 3 times. So essentially, as we keep using this ability continuously, then it will increase in damage. But it does mean if we deviate from using it, then it resets back to 1. So it's a very good ability for focused DPS where you're not going to be getting interrupted often. So it means that you'll need other characters to be defending, because if Hack defends, then that also resets it. You'll need other characters to be healing, because if Hack uses a repair kit, guess what? That resets it. So it's good as long as Hack is not having to do anything else except for use Burning Trigger. Alright then, affinity increase between Hack and Malt. Good. Wow. That was terrible. I hope the boss isn't that bad. Spoiler alert, it's gonna be even worse. Oh, and we're gonna have to spend so many action points to get rid of the negative effects. Because unlike fear, the injury and the depression is a bit complicated to get rid of. A child in battle has been injured or knocked out. Yeah, no shite. What was your first clue there, Sherlock? Battles will be seriously affected if you do not act. Buddy, they've already been seriously affected. Let's use the dormitory and the Taranis to get them back on their feet. A child has become depressed from the severe stress of battle. I was almost distressed because of the severe stress of battle. Depressed children cannot use skills or link attacks. Have another child talk to them and cheer them up. Okay. The laundry room is now unlocked! Yay! Thank you! Laundry! Yep, that's exactly what we need right now. We just got bin bagged, but hey, we can do laundry now. I'm so excited. I am so happy to be able to do my shagging laundry. Oh gee, Kyle doesn't feel like doing anything. I wonder why. In fact, everyone who's depressed won't actually be showing what they want to do until they're not depressed. Oh yeah, laundry is ready to be done. That's fabulous. We have laundry now. Meanwhile though, we have more important things to do. Like the fact half our crew has been demolished. That's a pretty bad thing. So then, how do we actually fix depression? Well, you primarily do it by talking to the characters. And it will sort of be like a, What do they call these? They'll be sort of like those chances to deepen your bond, except now you have to get them right for them to be undepressed. You will get multiple chances, and the progress does stack up, so inevitably you will get rid of it eventually, but it's best to cure the depression efficiently. So let's give it a shot. God save us. I think we can save each other. I think that makes her most happy. I think that's what fixes it instantly. Okay, I'll try. So yeah, May is feeling all better, so now that depression is gone, thank goodness. And as you can see, if you fail some of these, it's going to cost you a lot of action points, because each attempt will take an action point. So then, wow, that jacked up the affinity. Oh yeah, and a link event can be triggered. Oh, okay, sure, yeah, let's do it. Oh wait, no, we can't. Because Hannah is also depressed. Okay. May, Hannah just fixed your depression. You can go off and fix her depression, right? I'm sure you would be feeling great to do that. How much longer will this war last? I can't take it anymore. Let's work to end it sooner. I think that gets her right as rain, right, Hannah? Okay. Yes, I want to save everyone and go home. So, yep, that makes Hannah real nice and happy. So now she's feeling all better. And now we'll definitely get a link event. Oh my goodness, yep, that's just copious amounts of affinity. Yay, Fuga Theater! We can have a break from constant depression and nearly dying. Hannah, tell me an old story. I told you about when you were little the last time, didn't I? Yeah, but I don't remember much when I was little, so I want to hear lots more. Is that so? Ah, she must not remember much from that time. It's around when her mother and father died, too. What's wrong? Oh, it's nothing. Malt was always doting over you, but I think I understand his reasons. Ooh, I wanna know. What I mean is, Malt is a sweet big brother. Okay then. So yay, we get a temporary break from constant depression and injuries. Isn't that nice? Another link attack powered up. Goody! Who else is feeling down in the dumps? Well, Kyle. Kyle's a bit demolished. We need to sort of just rearrange his face and put it back together. And also, Kyle doesn't feel like doing anything. Yeah, bit of an issue. So then, the injuries and knockouts. So this is sort of the one saving grace of the dormitory. You don't ever want to use it, or even have to use it. But if you want to get rid of knocked out characters and get them back, or cure injuries, you need to bring them here. It's unfortunate, it's a tragic use of 5 action points, but like, this boss is already going to be devastating. We don't really need injured characters. We're going to get enough injuries in the boss, we don't need to carry over the ones from the last fight. Alright then. So, they're back up, their injuries are gone. Okay. What do people actually want? Well, Hack is still depressed. We should go and fix that up. Go down. Hack, where are you? Hack? Hacky boy. Are you off hacking something again? I bet he's on the roof then. Can't really think of any place else he would be. We're gonna get to the workshop. Believe me, we're gonna have to get to the workshop. I think we've proven our stats are not enough. But first, we need to cure Hack's depression. Wah, I can't stop crying. I think let it all out. I think that, oddly enough, is the one that makes him most happy. Okay then, that did make him happy. Well, I say happy, he's still crying copiously, but at least his depression is gone. He cried his depression out. What a strategy. And now that made lots of affinity. Now then, let's switch back to Hannah. And let's get down there and upgrade. Although, what do people actually want? Oh yeah, laundry. Yeah,
Laundry. Chick actually wants to do laundry. So how do we do laundry? Well, by going up here into the laundry room. Funnily enough, Chick is already here. So then, why for laundry? This is the laundry room! By doing the laundry with another character, you can deepen their bond and increase their affinity. However, you will have no more clothes to wash until the next intermission, so you can only do this once. It's a quick way to increase two children's friendship. Okay, so Hannah, Chick, laundry demolition job. There we go. And that is how you do the laundry. Laundry was successful! Yay! Because you can fail laundry, apparently. Well, I mean, I've failed laundry before. Shrunk many clothes. Alright then. Lots of affinity. So yeah, Chick feels great because she wants to do laundry. It's now done. And now Hannah and Chick's affinity has increased greatly. Well, has greatly increased, that's how they phrase it. I have to say things weirdly, apparently. A new entry has been added to the library. Cool! Oh yeah, and now... No, not enough for another link event, but boy, that's a lot. Hey there, roof battery. Gotta love yourself some roof batteries. You know, you really should explore your house's roof more. There's probably, like, 90% of the time, there's gotta be a roof battery. You could save so much money. Think about what you're missing out on. Alright then. Upgrades. We need upgrades. And all we can do is a reactor upgrade. Dang it. We need more metal plates. Well, thankfully we have a great way to fix that pretty soon. Oh yay, Kyle came to help. Thank you, Kyle. Alright then. Upgrading was successful. And that's a whole lot of experience. Okay then. So, does anybody want to plant anything? No, but Kyle. Why do I get Kyle and Hack's names mixed up so often? Hack wants to scope the surroundings in the observation room. Now that's a great one to do because observing the surroundings doesn't actually cost action points. So that's basically a free point on a bingo card or something. So yeah, go ahead and observe. Dale's Burman Frontline Camp. A frontline camp occupied as a base in the wastelands when the Burman army advanced into Dale. The camp is commanded by the two old generals, Baum and Stollen. Yes. A new entry has been added to the library. Good. And Hack is happy, right? No, he's not happy. Oh, is that one of the rare ones where you actually need to do it as the character who wants it to be done? Observation room, observe. He's still happy, right? Yeah, you're still happy. Okay, good, good. Now then, what else can be done? Sleeping. Guys, we have already wasted too much action points on sleeping. But Bora wants to talk to someone. So that's fine, because I know Chick has a link event, and the link events don't cost action points to do, so... Yep, let's go and find wherever Boron is. Okay, he's in the kitchen. Oh no, Boron's in the kitchen, we gotta go stop him. He's gonna eat everything. Yeah, look at that, he's demolishing our bread. This must be stopped. We will stop it with Fuga Theater. Boron! Boron! It's horrible! Nani? What's the matter, Chick? We're running out of food, so we need to save our sweets! Oh no! That is terrible! But I guess it was bound to happen. It's so sad! Don't cry. Think of something fun. It'll make you feel better. Like eating even if I'm not hungry? How about a chat? Chat about something. I'd probably just talk about food. Okay, maybe if we think of ways to have fun, it will be fun. Yes. Alright, I'll try to think of something. Okay then. Well, so much for stopping Boron from eating our food. Apparently the stocks are already low. Thank you, Boron. But hey, at least he feels great. The rest of us are gonna starve to death, but as long as Boron feels good, that's all that really matters, right? Yeah, he's just licking his paws. God, look at him just demolish our bread supplies. Okay then. Notebook. What else could we potentially do? Sox wants to explore some ruins. We've already expeditioned to death of this episode, and I really want to get some resources to actually upgrade. I know we can get some metal plates from level 2 fishing, right? So yeah, at level 1, difficulty 1, we can get rusty barrels, small and large, to use batteries and iron scraps. If we jack it up to difficulty 2, we get all of that, but also a little more. So we get rusty cartridges, rusty coils, rusty breech, used batteries, iron scraps, and the metal plates, which we desperately need. So yeah, let's go ahead and do it. We do have an 80% success for it, so we could fail, actually. But Chica's gonna jack it up just a tiny bit. I appreciate it. So then, it was successful. Metal plates? No. Okay. We'll try it again. We scrap fish. We get helped by Mei. And Chick this time. So it's a 90% chance for success. So we do it again. It was successful. Metal plates. No. Okay. Watch them not give me any metal plates. So we get helped by Kyle this time. At least we're getting different company each time. Scrap fishing was successful. Metal plates? Absolutely not. Never. Okay. We're gonna try it again. We're gonna get helped by Mei. Please, metal plates. Eventually. Just a couple. Highly successful. Show me the metal. Yes! 2 metal plates. 4. I think. And Hannah's level 13? Good. Does that mean we have enough to upgrade the armor? Oh! Oh, it's the iron scraps. I didn't even think about that. Iron scraps can show up, right? Yeah. Could have had iron. I guess we'll scrap fish one more time. Don't give me all the iron scraps right now, though. Oh no, they're gonna do it. Okay, no iron scraps. I am both somewhat sad, but also happy about that. Okay. Yeah, no more action points. Everyone did get healed up, right? Didn't complete as many tasks as I would have hoped for. Yeah, it wouldn't have been too hard to have Malt talk to someone. Oh well. There's really nothing for it but the doing now, is there? Go back to battle. This is going to get insane. We're not even going to start off with full resources. There's no way that repairs everything. Nope. 60 SP. Okay. Alright, we're here. Here it comes! That's the tank in the reports! Look at the size of that thing! Can we really do this? Don't lose your focus, you pea-brained pups! Inarguably, these young folk lose conviction so easily. How can we ever entrust the future of the Burman Empire to them? You know, I agree with you, Stollen. Just apply that to America, and yeah, no. We cannot trust the young folk. They do lose conviction. Okay then, onward with the cutscene. I just find that quite funny. Huh? What? What is that? Is it really a tank? Unbelievable! In all my years on the battlefield, I've never seen anything like it! Where is everyone? I'll never forgive you if you ever hurt everyone. Let Mom and Dad go. They're just children. How could they be controlling it? This may be our chance. Let's finish these old fogies and get Mom and Dad back. I'm not sure about this, but I'll fight too. These guys look stronger than we've seen before. Watch out, you two.
Okay, then. Here we go.
You little rascals! I'll teach you the consequences for defying adults! And when it's done, let's take that tank off their hands, shall we, old boy? It certainly piqued my interest.
Or, that's not actually what he said. He said curiosity.
Whoops!
Anyway, boss time. So then, Tillzer, battle helicopter with high evasion. It uses troublesome skills to restore Gorbon's HP and armor, so focus your attacks on it first. So yes, this is pretty much our real boss fight, and it's a duo! Gorbon, tank with thick armor and high attack. It uses a skill that inflicts fear. It has a devastating combo attack with Tillzer, so eliminate Tillzer first. So yeah, these two. I'm pretty sure Stollen is the one in the helicopter and Baum is the one in the tank. They basically have their own version of a link attack. And oh my god, it is devastating. It is basically a 20-hit attack that has an amazing chance of applying fear. Now, Tillzer, we have not actually seen helicopters yet, but Tillzer, along with most of the other Berman's helicopters, also has an ability called Bee Sting and Bee Storm. They are basically like the riot grenades, but they are far more consistent in actually hitting you, and the stun lasts even longer. Now, Tillzer also has a special ability he can use on himself that increases his evasion, so using a hefty amount of machine guns is pretty good, as it means you'll be hitting him and therefore stunning him consistently, as he actually takes 2 machine gun hits to stun, and he has an armor of 2. So yeah, he can take a long time to take out despite having less health than the tank. Now then, Gorbon. It does have 4 armor points. Not as much as the Zyklon Mark 3s, but it's still a lot. And he has quite a few abilities. He does have attacks that inflict fear. He also has another version of the attack that doesn't inflict the fear, but deals even more damage. Oh yeah, these guys are just devastating. So then, you want to focus down the helicopter first, otherwise he's just gonna keep healing this guy for both his health and his armor. So then, we want to change our setup real quick. Mostly, we just want Kyle in here as a machine gunner. So then, Kyle, get on in here. Good. Okay. Return to battle. So then, let's go ahead and use a piercing shot. Get the helicopter's armor down as quickly as possible. Now, keep in mind, their sort of link attack thing that they can do, they can perform it at any time. Good god, that's a 10% chance to apply burns. So, you basically always need to be ready to just lose a third of your health. If you're not at all times, then you're going to go down in a ball of flames. Now, I know there's some certain pattern to them using the ability. I think they can only do it about once every 5 turns. But it can be very unpredictable, thereby making the boss even more deadly. Try the cannon. No? Okay. Defend. Okay. Now the good thing about Tillzer is his actual damage output isn't that good. It's just the fact that he can stun you and heal Gorbon that makes him so irritating to deal with. Let's go ahead and defend. Because keep in mind, with their sort of link attack thing they can do, Gorbon is the one who activates it, and it does consume his turn.
But even though both of them have to be alive for it to go, it doesn't take Tillzer's turn. So he can actually use his abilities immediately after using the link attack, which is actually how I died the first time I fought these guys. These guys are, oh, they're just a little bit insane. I mean, they're two old generals. You would expect them to kind of be good at the whole war thing, but this is just oppressive. Okay, he's gonna add stealth. That's gotta mean that he lasts way longer than he needs to. Yep, even machine guns have a chance to miss. Great. Just incredible. I guess we can use Hack's cannon on the tank so that we progress towards delaying him. Air Blast X. Okay. So this is basically his super attack that can miss and not even be added to the equation. But the Air Blast X is basically just a super upgraded version of what the majority of Zyklons have. Okay. Get a cannon hit. What is he gonna do? Just machine guns. I say that like it's not problematic. I mean, just machine guns. No, it's an issue, but it's not the deadliest thing he could have pulled out. Okay, then. Please hit. No. This is worth a shot. We really should defend. Okay, yep. Bee Sting Y. And he has these special versions of the bee stings. Oh god, the checkmate. Oh, and it's undefended because he just used the bee sting. Yep. At this rate, you'll have to use the soul cannon. Well, I'm not, I've kind of disallowed myself from using that, so yeah, sorry. Oh god, okay. Well, hey, you know, soul cannon is available. Disallowed myself from using it, but you know, it's the thought that counts. So yeah, now everyone has a very powerful fear. Pretty sure it's actually a tad bit stronger than the normal fear that you get. Or maybe it's just the fact that, oh yeah, because it's 80% chance on the tank. So I think it's just the fact that the stealth is stacking with the fear, meaning that, yeah, we miss like half the freaking shots. Okay. What we really need right now is some form of healing. And I'm supposed to be showing off the new characters off properly, so Chick, you can get over here and be a healer for just a moment. There we go. Bit more health, bit more health. Oh, he's gonna do funny business. Ouch. Defend. Okay. Oh, yeah, we're getting wild now. Please get our health back up. Man, the fear combined with the evasion bonus that Stollen can get is just crazy. Oh, another Steel Tornado X. Yeah, it's a 5-hit attack instead of the usual 8-hit. It's just very interesting variants of the abilities that enemies usually have. Okay, thank you, Chick. Okay. He really loves those machine guns. Which is a good thing, because at least that means he's not constantly stunning us. Which he's usually doing. Okay. Hit him again. Hit him again. And kind of like the thing with Pretzel, because Gorobon is technically damaged, but it's not big enough to make a heal worth it, Tillzer isn't really going to go with it right now, most of the time. Because again, it's so little damage, it will waste some of the turn. Okay, let's go ahead. Machine gun, because I know that's going to hit, and then defend with Chick. Oh, please don't do the link. Oh my god, again, undefended. Oh, their timing is just spot on today, isn't it? Oh, and Chick is injured. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. We just really need to get that helicopter out of the sky.
It's just crazy right now.
Okay. Wow, big hits. No, don't stealth up again. It's not allowed. Oh, and we have nothing to really reduce his evasion rate. Oh, he's got to be getting close, right? Ooh, thank you. Just checking. Oh, wait, we can stun them. Oh, yeah. Now they're bosses, but you actually can still use the stuns on them. Oh, that's great. Oh, that's just great. Stun him right now, please. That would be amazing. Yes! And he's gonna be about dead because of that. Oh, May got knocked out. Well, thank you for your assistance, May. We're gonna need someone new. Hannah. Not supposed to be an episode where we use Hannah all the time, but everyone else is kind of just getting injured, so yep, that's just how it's going. Sucks to not have a second machine gun, but oh well. Right now, we just really need some heals. And I realize I just used a heal of Hannah, even though I could have just done it with Chick and got it for free. Yeah, sometimes you just don't think when you're stressed, do ya? Please die. That means die. Yes, that means big explodey boom thingy. That's what we bought him. Thank you. Stollen is finally dead. Okay then. Lullaby. And now we can start focusing on Grobian without too much issues about worrying about him getting healed. So then, we will keep Kyle there, but now we're going to bring out the big guns. Malt. Hack. Let's go ahead and finally close the curtain on these two, shall we? Yeah, that would be great. Now then, because I know this is still going to take a long time. No, Twin Sparks isn't going to help. But what we can do is... Ooh, we can start using Burning Trigger. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that right freaking now. So right now, the damage is pretty average. Later on, as we keep on using it, it will get bigger as long as it's not getting interrupted. And yeah, let's give Malt some bravery right now. Because right now, I still want to get the armor down before we really spend too much SP on much else. Okay then, so continue using Burning Trigger, and this time, because it's the second use of it, and he has less armor, even more effective. And yeah, Malt's hitting big because of his damage buff, and now Grobian is about out of armor. Whoa, no, use the Burning Trigger, This is kind of one of my favorite bosses, fun fact. I just love how it's designed. Well, that is going to be our SP supply done. We can still get the last of his armor down, though. So let's go ahead and empty the tank doing that. We are officially on no SP. Perfect. So now it's just a case of gun him down before he guns us down. Come on, we can do this. Defend real quick from his next attack. Oh, come on, Hack. We're almost done. Finish him! Yes! Oh. Well, that was an insane chapter. And it's only gonna go downhill from here. Oh my. Exactly 69 turns. Nice one, Kyle. And hey, May leveled up. Not that she can make much use of it right now, because it's very nearly the end of the episode and she's injured. But, you know, hey. She learned. She learned from getting smacked around. That's what matters. What? How? Yes, how are you alive after that?
Retreat!
Oh, thank goodness we did it.
All right, we beat him. They are withdrawing! Victory is ours! Let everyone go! Now! Now speak! Where are Mommy and Daddy?
The children promised to spare the two old men in exchange for information, which they grudgingly complied.
Alright, fine. Don't fire. We'll tell you what you want to know. Just don't shoot. You give us no choice. They were probably taken to the factory in the south. Near the mining area of Shetland. That's all we know.
True to their word, the children let the two generals go, who promptly turned tail and ran. Trusting in this new information, the crew pressed onward. Yeah, little bit of a spicy decision, just trusting information from your enemy. Yeah, and the fact you let him go, yeah. How did they survive the explosions? I'm still really curious on that. It is unfortunate they were not here. Grandma, Grandpa, where did you go? We'll find them soon, I know it. So let's hang on a little longer, okay? Regardless, we should follow what these Burman generals said and head south.
Okay then. Dale's Burman for Frontline Camp, several days later.
Lieutenant Muscat, the Burman military forces in this camp have been entirely decimated. I see. Good work, soldier. Everything suggests that the Burman crossed path with an unknown third party. We may be able to discover more if we follow these colossal tracks left behind.
Yes, so the Gasco military is actually catching on to what's going on.
Okay. Oh, and we have another chapter art to rank. Now, sadly, I'm gonna have to say 6 of 10. It is good, but partly because of the largeness of the image, then the detail is a bit less sharp. Now, mostly it's because it is a big scale image. So I guess I'll take it up to about 6.5, just because there is a lot going on here. There's, you know, Hack and Chick absolutely eating the food, May and Hannah being surprised, Boron looking out a window. So there is a lot going on, so I can't blame it too much. But because of that sort of overextension, that means that there's just so much to do, and it means that everything gets a little bit less detail. Again, not an artist, I have no real right to be ranking these, but that is my uneducated art opinion. And this illustration was by Koki. Well, thank you, Koki. I know I just ripped your art to shreds, but it was still good.
Okay then, so we have made it to another town, which we will be getting to next episode, along with the new Burman report. So, until then, consider liking and subscribing, and I will see you next episode. Wow, what a chapter. Now, present me has to go and make sure that future me actually goes and finds that clip that he said he was going to hopefully show, maybe. I don't really trust future me. But oh well. Have a good day, everyone.